today to share with you about the Lord Jesus Christ and about his salvation. It says, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and said, shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus. Jesus was not just a prophet. He was the Lord Jesus. The Lord Jesus means he was perfect, that he knew no sin. Anybody you know is not perfect. I'm not perfect. But he is the Lord Jesus because he is perfect. That's why he had to die on the cross, because he was a perfect sacrifice for you. He's the Lord Jesus. It says in the Bible, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. General Mao, Hitler, all the great and bad leaders of history will have to bow before Jesus and worship him. So say here, if you confess Jesus is Lord, some of you confess porn as Lord, sex as Lord, drugs as Lord, money as Lord, your car as Lord, your pension as Lord. It says here, if you confess Jesus Christ as Lord, do you believe that he's the Lord today? That if you confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus with thy mouth. Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. When I came to know the Lord, I went to see my mate who was a drug dealer. I went into his flat and there were drug dealers all around the flat. And he said, Bertie, why did you believe? You don't need to believe. And at that moment, I confessed Jesus in front of those drug dealers. I'm not ashamed of confessing the name of Jesus. Are you ashamed of Jesus' name today? It says, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart. Do you believe in your heart that he is the Son of God? Do you believe in your heart that he died on a cross for you? Do you believe in your heart that he shed his blood on that cross? Do you believe in your heart that he was nailed to that cross for you? Do you believe in your heart that he died on that cross and shed his blood for you? Do you believe in your heart? You see, you can know it in your head, but does it go down to your heart? You can know something in your head, but it doesn't translate into your heart. Do you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died for you? If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart, then the Bible says you are saved. It says, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. One day when we die, we come before God, and God says, did you confess and believe in my Son? And if you say no, you say, depart from me, I never knew you. But if you say yes, he says, enter my kingdom in heaven. If you confess Jesus in your life and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, you shall be saved. Who do you confess today? Who do you believe in? Do you believe in your pension? Do you believe in the lottery tickets that you buy? Do you believe in the gambling? Do you believe in the sex? Do you believe in the drugs? What do you believe in? Will you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord? Will you believe in your heart that he died for you? And if you do, you'll be forgiven. If you do, you'll be cleansed. If you do, you'll be restored. If you do, you'll find peace and love in your life. If you confess and believe that Jesus Christ is Lord, rivers of joy will flow in your heart. Rivers of peace will flow in your life. Rivers of hope will flow in your life. Your life will change and there'll be peace and power in your life. You'll move in a different way with hope and joy in your life. If you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you turn away from the drugs, you turn away from the sex, you turn away from the gambling, you turn away from the pride, you turn away from the worldliness, you turn away from political correctness, and you turn to Jesus. When you turn to Him, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Rejoice, and again I say, rejoice. There is a joy and a peace in Christ. A joy that you can have. A hope that you can have. The rivers of God, the joy of the Lord, will come and fill you. The joy of the Lord will give you strength. The joy of the Lord will give you peace. He'll give you hope and grace and love in your life. If you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that He died for you, you can go to church and you can go every week, but it doesn't mean to say that you believe Him in your heart. You can be seen as a good person, but it doesn't mean to say that you believe Jesus in your heart. The devil believes Jesus, but not in his heart. It didn't change his life. But you need it. You need His love in your life. You need the joy in your life. You need the hope in your life. You need the peace in your life. And He will give you the love and peace. He will bind up your broken heart. If you're lost and broken today, there is hope for you today. For He'll come and comfort you, for He is the God of all comfort. Come to Me, all you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He will give you rest and peace in your heart and life if you trust in Him. But if you trust in political correctness, you're going to go to hell. Political correctness is not biblical correctness. It's not what the Bible teaches. Scotland needs the Bible, not political correctness. Political correctness comes and goes, but the Word of God is forever and ever. Chairman Mao in China had a day of burning, and he burnt all the Bibles. Today, there are 70 million Christians in China. Scotland's political correctness will change, but the Bible will last forever. Trust in Him now while you can. Trust Him today. It's the only way for you. The only hope. Don't follow political correctness. It will smash your mind. You need to be renewed in the Word of God. You need to be renewed in the Word of God. You need to be renewed in the Word of God. The whole Word of God in your life. Are you alright, mate? What's up? Well, it's called democracy, guys. Get used to it. It's called democracy. People died in Scotland for you to have free speech and me. God bless you. Have a lovely day, sir. Have a lovely day. Have a lovely day. God bless you. No, I'm here to preach the gospel. Jesus Christ died on the cross. He gave His life. He died for you. God bless you, sir. Have a lovely day. Jesus died for you. He gave His life. Don't swear like against a rapper, sir. Jesus Christ died on the cross. He gave His life for you. He shed His blood for you, sir. He gave His life. He died on the cross. He gave His life for you, sir. Whatever you believe, I respect, sir. God bless you. Jesus Christ died on that cross. And He shed His blood for you on that cross. He died for you on that cross. And if you trust Him, you can know His peace. There is power, power, oh, unworking power in the God of the land. There is power, power, oh, unworking power in the blood of the land. Scotland, come back to Jesus. He loved you and died for you on that cross. Come on, Scotland. You need Christ. You need the Lord. You need the Lord today. You need Jesus today. Hallelujah. We love him. Come to his love today. Come to know his love in your life. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood. Which is better? A night smoking, working bucket or a night praising Jesus? No, a night praising Jesus. Hallelujah. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood for you. God bless you. Have a lovely day. You great people. I've come first time up this way, and you're lovely people. You've been really nice. But God bless you. We're not here to condemn. We're here to share the love of Christ, that you might know his love. God bless you, and have a lovely day. Thank you. God bless you.
Jason.
Thank you, ladies. Thanks for standing with me. Amen. God bless you. What's your name? Amy. Alice. God bless you. Oh, Amy. Just the problem, it's just the problem. But I'm happy, you know, and as you watch it.
Ha, ha, ha.